Excuse
me. God ain't forgetting what those motherfuckers did to this place, Mr. Clay. I won't either.
Ours, the goddamn bayou most definitely is not one of
himself. You can take that.
show's in and I'm hooked. The best part of it, though, watching him
you get lost, excited boy?
About it. Having that to talk to him about. Feels good.
You think I forgot what you did? You can blame Mark Connor all you want, but it was your men who ambushed
us. My men were following orders. We got rules.
Not my fucking problem that you people don't understand.
Yeah, well, I'm about to make it your fucking problem.
What shit is this, then?
Goddamn. If it ain't the city's favorite pot-licking donkey, Thomas Burke.
The fuck did you just say to me?
Put the gun down, Burke. It's gonna take all four of us to bring down Marcano, so I don't want any more of this stupid bullshit.
Bring down Marcano? These two used to work for Marcano. And this one? Do you know how many of my men this canard killed because Marcano told him to? Fuck him, and fuck you if you think I'm ever gonna trust
these
two.
Hey, get the fuck out then. There's no sweat off my ass.
You don't trust him? Good. Because I don't trust any of them. But that doesn't change the fact that I destroyed Barbieri's operations, killed Doucette and those other redneck motherfuckers, and saved Joe ass from Greco's men. So here's what you need to decide right fucking here now. Either fall in line or get the fuck out. Just know, second you step out that door, your name's getting added to my list right beneath Marcano's. Now, if we're all done acting like goddamn children, let's go over the plan. In order to bring down an organization the size of Marcano's, we need to eliminate the people at the base and work our way up. It's the same thing I did not.
I know the military filled your noggin with all manner of tactics and schemes, but let's not overtake this shit.
Say we go out to his house and shoot him. Shouldn't take more than an hour or so, depending on traffic.
And what you think gonna happen after? Everybody else just gonna lay down and die, you stupid-ass motherfucker?
Cassandra's right. Just killing Marcano doesn't get us anywhere. One of his brothers will take over, and we're right back where we started. So, first, we go after his lieutenants. Then, once they're killed, we seize their territory and move on to the capos. Once the lieutenants and the capos are killed, Marcano will be isolated and alone. And that's when we go after him.
Hold on, what happens to those territories we get from Marcano's guys?
Once it's in our hands, I'll decide who gets to run the day-to-day. I give you a district, you get the rackets and everything else. But I'm also counting on you to hold it. Keep that bastard from reclaiming it. One last thing. Y'all know that building that's going up across the lake? He's building a casino. Marcano's constructing this so we can go legit. All his money's tied up into that thing, so once he figures out what we're up to, it'll limit his options. More importantly, it's an emotional attachment. Emotions make people irrational, greedy. So that's where we hit it. Right in the goddamn heart.
Hey, nice speech. Think they bought it?
Okay. They're all too greedy or pissed off at Marcano to back out now.
At least until one of them decides to try the crown on for size.
Well, if it comes to that, I'll handle it. The photos were a nice start and all, but I'm gonna need some actionable intel on those lieutenants. A place of business, where I can find them, you name it.
The dossiers are nearly complete. I'll be ready to move when you are. I was also able to recruit some concerned citizens who are more than happy to share what they know about Sal's coalition of WAP assholes. Information on how to contact them will be included with the other intel.
Appreciate it.
Sure you don't need a ride?
Oh, I do my own driving.
Ooh. And the systematic killing of Marcano's capos and lieutenants, that was part of the plan.
Well, you're playing fucking patty cake, Christ.
Look, you want to bring somebody down, you destroy the foundation they're standing on. It's the same basic op we ran over Nam.
Let me know if you need anything else, Shelby.
Pearly used to put these under our beds. Thought they keep us safe.
Fear drives people to seek out all manner of protection. God, the invisibles, the Loa. But sometimes, that is not enough.
No weapon formed against us shall prosper, right?
Not with a 45 in my hand. The white government says we don't have a right to arm ourselves and we can't be trusted. But the folks around here, all they looking for is a little peace of mind. There are stashes of guns hidden in this city. I need you to steal them.
You sure this is about the Hollow? I don't need you starting a revolution. Fucking everything up.
When you out there running around killing all those crackers, what do you think people will see? I tell you what they see. A crazy nigga. A nigga part of a savage whole that needs to be exterminated.
Well, I don't give a shit one way or another. They can come after me.
And what happens when you're not around and another black man or woman is, huh? We all the same to them. Don't you think the people of this neighborhood, the mechanic, the housewife, have a right to defend themselves?
History tells me that giving you more guns might be unhealthy for me.
It's not like that. Not anymore. I'll see to it they get in the hands of the right people.
I'll see what I can do.
And don't worry. I'll make sure you benefit as well.
Don't push me, Cassandra.
You know, at some point you're gonna have to trust me.
Maybe. We ain't there yet.